Consider this scenario. A more accurate machine learning model is developed every month and added to the main branch. To deploy the model, you must download it to your machine, package and deploy it. However, as you might have other responsibilities, it could take days or even weeks before you can complete the deployment, which slows down the release process and takes up valuable time that could be spent on other tasks. Would it be great if the model could be automatically deployed to production whenever a new version is pushed into the main branch? That is when continuous deployment comes in handy. What is continuous deployment? In the previous video, we discussed the use of continuous deployment or CI for testing code changes in a pull request before merging them into the main branch. Upon successful testing of the code and model, continuous deployment can be utilized to automatically deploy a new model to production. Automated model deployment can provide numerous advantages, such as quicker time to market for new machine learning models and improved efficiency by reducing the resources required for deployment. This video will show you how to create a CD pipeline for a machine learning project. The source code of this video can be found in the description below. To build a CD pipeline, we will perform the following steps: saving the model object and its metadata, uploading the model to a remote storage location, setting up a platform to deploy the model, and creating a GitHub workflow to deploy the model into production. Let's explore each of these steps in detail. We will use MLEM, an open source tool that simplifies model deployment. To save a model using MLEM, begin by calling its save method. This method is similar to joblib.dump, but it has an additional argument called sampleData. This argument helps MLEM automatically infer the data schema, which is useful when serving the model later on. This code is saved in the file train.py under the source directory. Running this file will create two files, a model file and a metadata file. The metadata file captures various information from a model object, including model artifacts, such as the model size, URI, and hash value, which is useful for versioning the model. Model methods, such as predict, inputs data schema, which includes its columns and the corresponding data types, and Python requirements used to train the model. It took me about 25 hours to create this video, including code example, recording, and editing, all to ensure that you get the most value from this video. So, if you have found the video helpful so far, I would really appreciate it if you could take a moment to click the like button. Your support will motivate me to create more content like this. Thank you. Next, we will push the model to a remote storage. By pushing the model to remote storage, we can store our models and data in a centralized location that can be accessed by GitHub workflow. We will use DVC for model management because it offers the following benefits. DVC enables keeping track of changes to model and data over time, making it easy to revert to previous versions. DVC can store models and data in different types of storage systems, such as Amazon S3, Google Cloud Storage, and Microsoft Azure Blob Storage. By versioning data and models, experiments can be easily reproduced with the exact same data and model versions. To integrate DVC with MLEM, we can use DVC pipeline. With the DVC pipeline, we can specify the command dependencies and parameters to create certain outputs in the dvc.yaml file. There are multiple stages in a typical dvc.yaml file, such as process, train, and evaluate. In this video, we will focus on the train stage. For more in-depth explanations about this pipeline, you can refer to the DVC video located above. In the train stage, we specify the outputs to be the following files. Specifically, the file model SVM is cached, so it will be uploaded to a DVC remote storage, but not committed to Git. This ensures that large binary files do not slow down the performance of the repository. The model svm.mlem is not cached, so it won't be uploaded to a DVC remote storage, but will be committed to Git. This allows us to track changes in the model while still keeping the repository size small. To run the train stage, type the following command on your terminal: dvc experiment run and the name of the stage. Now the model is modified, we are ready to push it to a remote storage location. To specify a remote storage location, click config under .dvc. In this file, we will specify the name of the remote storage and its URL. If you are trying this out, make sure to replace the URL with your S3 bucket. Next, we will push the modified files to the remote storage location named read-write. Let's figure out a platform to deploy our model. MLEM supports deploying your model to the following platforms: Docker, Heroku, Fly.io, Kubernetes, and SageMaker. This project chooses Fly.io as a deployment platform, as it is easy and cheap to get started. To create applications on Fly.io in a GitHub workflow, you will need an access token. Here's how you can get one. First, go to Fly.io, sign up for a Fly.io account, log in, click Account in the top right corner, then click Access Tokens. Create a new access token and copy it for later use. Now it comes to the exciting part, creating a GitHub workflow to deploy your model. We will create a workflow in the file publish.yaml inside the following directories. Here's what the file looks like. The on field indicates that the pipeline will be triggered when there is a push event to the main branch and modifications have been made to the model's metadata file. The publish model job includes the following steps: checking out the code, setting up the Python environment, installing dependencies, pulling a model from a remote storage location using DVC, setting up FlyCTL to use Fly.io, and finally deploying the model to Fly.io. With the command MLEM deployment run Fly.io, the name of the app, and the path to the model. For a more in-depth understanding of this file, I suggest referring to the GitHub Actions documentation, which I will link in the description below. Note that for the job to function properly, it requires AWS credentials to pull the model and Fly.io's access token to deploy the model. To ensure the secure storage of sensitive information and enable GitHub Actions to access them, we will use encrypted secrets. To create encrypted secrets, click Settings, Secrets and Variables, Actions, and New Repository Secret. Insert the name and the value of your secret. Repeat the step to create the following secrets. That's it. Now let's try out this project and see if it works as expected. To try out this project, go to this repository and follow the instruction under Try It Out. After creating a pull request, a GitHub workflow will be triggered to run tests on the code and model. After all checks have passed, click Merge Pull Request. Once the changes are merged, a CD pipeline will be triggered to deploy the model. To view the workflow run, click the workflow, then click the Publish Model job. After the workflow has finished running, click the link under the Deploy Model step to view the website to which the model is deployed. And you will see a sample dataset automatically created by MLEM. To apply the model on this dataset, simply click Try It Out, leave the default values or change them to something else, click Execute. We can see that the response code is 200, which means that the request is successful and the predicted value is 6. Now, any new model will be automatically deployed when it is merged into the main branch. How cool is that? Ensuring reproducibility is not only important for the models themselves, but also for the notebooks used to analyze pipeline outputs. The following video will teach you how to create reproducible notebooks with Hex.